Hi guys, welcome down to Lumine, and we are on the third golf course here, which is the Ruins course. And it's a very fun nine-hole course, is what we've been told by Andy the head pro. And I'm not sure what fun means just yet. But if you actually just look down there, when they started to build this golf course, they started to discover Roman ruins. And there's how many patches on the course?
Just three on this hole.
Three on this hole?
Yeah.
Oh, is that it? And after
That's it,
yeah. Okay, so uphill par four. Over that tree.
At that bunker on the top of the hill there. Go.
Pretty good. Well then.
Nice. We're off the bottom, but should be good.
Pretty good.
Little low fader down there. Okay.
When you said that three on this hole, I was like, what are we going to find later?
Okay, so what other format could we play? We've not played stroke play, have we?
No.
Let's play stroke play.
Stroke play.
On this fun golf course, which I think might be a bad idea.
No, it's a good idea.
Okay.
Birdie chances on every hole.
Brilliant.
Apart from this one.
Triple bogey chances.
Apparently the greens are tripped up. And at one of the greens, you've got to stay tuned for this. We've not seen it yet.
No,
there is a bunker in the middle of the green. By the way, guys, this is going to be one monster video of all nine holes. So sit back, get yourself a drink, and enjoy. And enjoy. It's coming down just near those birds. Yeah. We didn't actually see it down, but it should be okay. Right. Let's get going.
Enjoy. It's coming down just near those birds.
So this is now down the first hole. This is one of the...
It's a big old footing for something, isn't it?
The old Roman ruins. And then just here on the left is definitely an old building of some description. Should we have a quick look?
Are we allowed in?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay, let's have a look in.
So I think it's a free drop if you go in here, but I mean, that is so amazing, isn't it? So literally started building on here, and I was like, guys, there's something here. Got a lizard on top of the rock there. I don't know if you can make that out, actually. It's quite camouflaged. So yeah, we're currently in the kitchen. Moving now into one of the bedrooms. Slightly feeling like there's going to be a snake somewhere.
A roving
snake. Cool, isn't it?
Yeah, it's cool.
That's interesting. Look at that. Like the,
I think what they've done is they've got the footings, and whenever the wall has basically fallen into disrepair, and they've taken the stones and they've redone the footing of it.
Is that what it is?
Yeah.
I was going to say, because that was quite clever if the Romans have done that as well.
Yeah.
Jump over this wall.
I'm not sure they had plastic mesh back then.
That's really cool. Awesome. So that's why this golf course is called the Ruins.
Always.
Hey guys, this is not just entertainment value, this is educational channel. If you're watching and should be doing homework, it's all right, you're learning about the Romans. Right, let's get up to the balls.
So Rick's got a second shot here, focusing up the hill, an open front of the green, but we have been told that the greens on this course are a little bit silly. I think Andy was saying that every year they do a couple of reenactments of the majors, and they do the masters on this course, and he was saying that they got the greens up to about 12 and it was carnage, were his precise words, carnage.
Got 184, playing 184 up the hill. I'm going to hit 6 iron. Just go at it.
Yeah, straight at it. Draggy towards that bunker.
In the bunker. Snaggy, horrible, like strike that.
Mate, I really won't worry, you're in the bunker. Anyone who's been watching the vlogs from over here knows that Rick's pretty much a man of the sand now.
I'm too close to the green there.
To be honest, it looks like quite a long bunker shot.
Actually,
I think you'll be able to, okay.
If you chipped it in that bunker, I'd have made up and down.
You probably made a birdie.
So we found Pete's just up this right-hand side rough. See the flag just popped on the top there.
152 playing 156.
So 152, but actually playing 156 yards. So that Bushnell with the slope setting on it has been a lifesaver this trip.
Yeah, to be honest, any time I've paid attention for it, I've always missed a green by about 30 yards left or right anyway, so okay. It could have been brilliant.
Okay.
I'll just never ever know.
That's a lie, you've been in it good. Right, what have you got? 8 iron?
No, I'm going to go 7.
Okay.
I've still got that lentil salad in me.
So. Yeah, we've just had lunch, so I felt a little bit heavier on that last shot as well. Heavy in strike, heavy in belly. Oh, that's gone left as well.
Oh, come on, look at the upslope.
Just over the bunker. I'm in it, Pete's just over it. Not the best starts.
So Rick did find the front left bunker. And
it kind of gathers a bit, doesn't it?
Yeah, the greens here do look very slopey. It seems to gather into a little bit of a bowl. I think you can actually see some grain on them, which is quite nice. That's a very, very good shot. I mean, you confused the hell out of your poor ball, but...
Oh, I thought I was going to go a bit more down that hill then.
Well, he was thinking about going right, and then you were telling it to go left. It was like, well, what do you want me to do?
Okay, Pete, just off the left side of the green, has avoided the bunker. Similar line shot to mine, so I might have learned a little bit from it. It's going to go left of the pin, then it's going to go up, and then straight back down the hill. Just let you know, Pete.
Okay.
That's what's going to happen.
Not a problem. So I'm going to have to come in and around your ball.
Yeah, because I'm not moving it.
Wow. Okay. Yeah, it didn't seem to kick on as much as I thought it would do that.
It seems like it was mega downhill, both of ours there. Two putts for par.
So, par chances, we're coming down and across the slope, so it should move a little bit right, do you think?
It's got to, hasn't it?
You would have thought so. You would have thought so. Oh, yeah, they did. Oh! Yeah,
I didn't ever start it really left.
Yeah, it kind of went right.
Five,
very
bad
quickly.
Start. It's not a ruin.
Oh, you were waiting for that, weren't you?
Pretty much.
Oh.
Pete for par. Learned a lot from that.
Can't deny it, I did learn. It's what you got to do, isn't it? You got to learn. Got to learn.
You know what they say, if you don't learn...
you don't learn. It's self-fulfilling, I think, Marvel.
Okay. Oh.
Right, so yeah.
It's getting late on. Okay, for par to take an early one stroke lead. Nailed it. Good putt. Good up and down.
Thank you very much.
Level par for Pete, one over for me. Normal service resumes. That's what we have to put up with. The paps. Ridiculous. Right, second hole, par 3, down the hill, 149. It's playing, it's 153, actually, as the crow flies. Flag's there just in the left front portion of the green. It looks like it's kind of
it's got like a
big bowl in the middle of it, so it's you've got to get on the right plateau here. I'm guessing you're hitting 8?
I'm going to go 9. Feels
I thought you might be hitting 9.
It's a little down.
It's a good hit, but it's slightly left. Unless it kicks off that bank. Oh, it has. Is it? Has it? Yes, it has.
It's not worked out too bad. A little bit pulley, but
it's
out. Okay.
You go in wedge
nine.
Thought so.
You know, we read each other so well.
Oh, well, you know, I've been working together for quite a long time now. And I'm always trying to hit it that little bit further. Rick's always trying to hit it.
With a fade?
A little bit less with a fade. Lovely little setting for this hole. Oh, hello.
It's a bit heavy. Go.
Front edge.
It was like a blade of grass heavy. Hello. On it as well, wasn't it?
All good.
Go. Front edge.
Rick, after coming up just slightly short, is putting. Is using a putter, which is good. Greenkeepers will be delighted to hear. And he's coming up the hill and it's going to drop away to the right hand side. Would you concur?
Yes.
Good.
Flag's there for a backstop.
Just in cases. Got to make precautions. Preparations. Something like that, again with P. So up and to the left. Break down. Big slope in this green. Break. Good effort, mate. It's a good putt, that. You can have that, but
no, we've got are we
properly doing everything? Yeah, good three.
No, it is. It was good.
You know what? So that's going to be on my Christmas list now. Dear Santa, I would like you to give Rick the present of taking a compliment. He'll be like, yeah, I'm all out of those people.
Yeah, listen, I'm not a genie. There's only so much I can do.
So I'm guessing this is going to be quite quick.
It's going to be rapido.
Should fall away. A little bit to the left as well, but mostly downhill. We get the pace right.
Just. 1 second, Pete. 1 second. Can we get the right vantage point for this? 1 second. Okay. Nice.
Is that all okay?
Yeah. Amazing. Every single hole, these cameras keep following us. Because they've got legs, they just walk from tee to tee.
This is why it takes us so long to do course walks.
Oh, we've been out here for 3 days. We played 2 holes. It's the theme park. See if we can catch some roller coaster action. Nope. Right, third hole, we've been advised not to hit driver, so Pete's gone with 3 wood. I've got the 2 iron out. It looks like a very, very narrow hole. You've got to shoot it in that gap there. Which that's all you've got.
There
is a tower at the top of the hill, the Roman watchtower. I would say it's on that. That's not Roman actually, watchtower,
no,
is it?
Not Roman, no.
Just a watchtower.
More Moorish, I think, maybe.
Okay, let's do this. Sorry, Pete's got hybrid, not 3 wood. Oh, it's a slight left shot, but absolutely fine.
Yeah, when I hit it, it was a good strike. When I hit it, I thought, oh no.
Oh no.
No, go left.
But it was okay. Yeah. It's worked
when
out fine.
It was a good strike.
Just a little bit of left on the watchtower.
It's at the watchtower, isn't it?
It's at the watchtower.
I think it falls fairway bunked, to be honest with
you. I do not blame you at all for that. If you watched any of the previous vlogs from here, you'll know Rick's fairway bunker performance has been unreal.
Yeah,
Great shot. Fantastic looking hole on camera, this as well. Straight down. Presume it's perfect.
It seemed it.
If not, we can edit.
Fantastic looking hole on camera, this as well.
So we've both found the fairway perfectly. Pete's just up on the left hill here. I'm just down in the right side. It's kicked just down on that right, but both in good spot for this green. Now, I'm not sure. I think we could have hit driver. There's a good...
Now we're in the middle of the fairway, yeah.
There's definitely a good 5 yard space down there for driver. Never been driver. What are you hitting? How far have you got?
I've got 116 yards and...
116.
I'm going to hit quite a special shot for you here, Rick.
Show me what you got.
Okay.
What are you going to hit?
I was going to hit a little wedge with a tiny touch of fade.
Okay.
It's going to pitch on the green.
Oh, this is your shot.
And roll down.
This is, and it's slightly into down breeze. Into down breeze. It switched pretty quickly then.
So it'll take off the spin.
Is it going to go? It did. Is it going to turn? Oh, it just needed a little bit of fade on it, didn't it?
Yeah.
Nice shot.
It started where I wanted it to, but...
Nice shot.
After a perfect tee shot, what are you going to go with?
I'm going to go a little low one as well.
A little low one as well.
It, got 105 in, then gap wedge.
Just to the left as well?
Yeah, a little at the flag, a little tiny low draw.
Oh, come on, be good. Be good.
That is mega, is that mega close?
I don't know, I can't see the bottom of the pin. It looked amazing.
I think that's mega close. Hello! Pete, do you think we should try and ever qualify for the Open? That was actually slightly unfortunate. It's pitched there. It took one hop and stopped. Pete gave me this though as we walked out the buggy, which is an indication that that's no gimme.
Line stroke play.
Oh yeah, I forgot with line stroke play. Damn. That was a beautifully executed shot. Right, let's see what's going on here, Pete.
Yeah.
Big swing from down here. Big time. Big time.
Crest of that hill and then move down. Let me off if it hits your ball.
I'm going to mark it. Cause I feel like it's going to be some level of a backstop for you. It's going quick. Okay, it's marked. Ooh.
Why did I just stop?
Stop what?
There was a fly on my arm. I was like, let's hit it quick in case it bites you. And now it's on my ear. Settle down.
Compose yourself.
Compose.
Okay. You got it?
I'm insect free. Flies all around me. They must like the smell of me. Come on.
A little bit off the right.
Oui.
Downhill, a little bit off the right. Par.
That, to be honest.
I thought you had that. Right.
Well, that's a
3-shot swing. Go on then, mate. Whack it in. Let's move on. Let me leave this hole behind. Let me just remember the good things that we've seen. Nice. Beautiful tee shot, wonderful approach.
Bit swinging this. Okay.
Very tricky 1.5-foot putt here. That's an amazing putt. How you hold it?
Back to level.
Oh, he just got a miss.
Back to level par. Let's crack on. By the way, there's no stopping this log. This is all 9 holes. So don't forget, sit back, enjoy, and we'll get on to the 4th.
That's a hell of a driving course, this already. I mean, there ain't a lot to aim for. That's the fairway. It goes around to the left. The green's in the distance. Not sure if it's a par 4 or a par 5.
Just left that big tree.
I think so, yeah. It's gone a little bit too far left, so that's no point zooming in. It's coming down.
We're not sure though, are we really?
Over there. Oh, there's another hole that runs along the left hand side, so I don't think you're going to be in any real bother.
Yeah, it turned a little bit in the air with me there, but I kind of, when I try and force a draw, it's not a good time for me.
And when it's not a good time for you, it ain't a good time for anybody.
Yeah, I shouldn't have tried to force the draw. Okay, Pete.
Yeah, same.
Plan. Just left, yeah, well, less to the right, but less to the left, sorry. Yeah, my left and right's very mixed up today.
Love the look of this course so far.
Eh? It looks great, doesn't it? Wind swirling, first bit of wind we've seen really since being in Spain.
The last hole was downwind, straight downwind.
Oh, that is so pure. Don't think we're going to see it down. Yeah, but amazing. Great drive.
Thank you.
Oh, that is so pure. Rick's just in the left-hand rough here. Ball slightly below his feet, but ball's lying okay. Pin is back.
Really into quite a strong wind here as well, isn't it?
Yeah, wind has picked up a little bit. So we've got 100 and...
I'm going to squeeze a wedge in there.
Squeeze it. 125 to go. Go for a low squeezer. Come back.
Oh man. I like that shot. I liked it a lot. So Pete, after his beautiful golf shot.
I was happy with that, I must
have. Has, let me guess this, 106 left in?
Yeah.
I know. I bushnelled it after you did. 106 left in, pin is back right. Very inviting little approach shot into here. You can kind of just see it.
Into wind on a hanging light. Only 106 yards, they're actually going to hit a little 9.
Okay.
Like a little tiny punchy 9.
I think that's the shot. Oh. Oh, lovely, lovely control, sir.
Yeah,
beautiful.
Happy with that.
Beautiful shot, well done.
Right, mate. I wouldn't exactly say that you've left the easiest bunker shot in the world for yourself here.
Not far off the green, am I?
Not far. Oh, I didn't realise you were thinking you were that close, though. Rick has literally just fallen into the bunker.
It's like a yard off here.
There's... Yeah, it's just got to be super soft hands, drop the club behind the ball and it's just going to pop out and roll down. Hopefully. That's probably as...
I didn't think I could leave it short.
That's actually pretty unlucky. That's actually pretty unlucky, that, but that was a good shot.
Right, Pete, great shot in from yourself. Lovely judgment of distance from 106 hitting 99. You've worked that out perfectly. Now you've left yourself with the probably easiest chance on this green for birdie.
Well, I certainly wouldn't say that, but I admire your confidence.
As in, there's many worse spots you could have been in than right now.
Oh well, yeah, 100%. Going down and off the right. I think it is outside right.
Yeah.
I think it's a mile outside right.
Up.
I just can't, I don't know. They look
sleek.
They look slick and they look very, very slopey, but the couple now where I've just over red those, but
it's okay.
So what are you now? You're level?
One over. Three put then.
What am I? Four.
Level.
I'm yeah. Par.
Put for a par. So again, pretty well, similar line to the bunker shot. It's downhill and
off the left.
Yeah, just off the left. Massive, good stroke here. Yeah, nice putt. Nice putt. Nice up and down, mate.
Thank you.
Stays at level. So we are on the fifth, somewhere around that, middle of the but nine holes. Very, very, well, great looking hole.
Yeah.
That's looking good. Is it just over? Almost. Took out a bird on the
bunker.
I think that's on the fairway because a bird took off.
Oops.
That stayed up long enough just to get the recording of it.
Yeah, I think it was okay. I'm going a different tactic.
Pete's going big stick.
Well, it's probably about 330, 340 maybe, about all the way back to the pin.
Okay.
It's 300 to the front of the bunker on the right. I'm thinking if I really do get hold of one, back up the hill.
You could get there.
Could get there. Well, you know what? We're going to find out.
You sure will? Downwind, it's got a chance. Been murdered, but it's slightly left.
Yeah, towards the car path, so.
Should be okay? Yeah.
So Rick found the rough, not the fairway bunker, which was a bit, he was actually gutted about.
Yeah, I'd rather, ooh.
Yeah, Rick actually hit a bird. He did hit a bird.
Yeah, don't it does that.
It's uphill, how far we got?
83.87.
Pins at the back of this green, it's quite a long undulating green this one.
You know because?
I had a little bit of a look at it, and that's what every other green's been like. Go on. Chase up. It's hard to get that.
My prediction is short.
Yeah, it didn't quite come out of there, really. However, it's putting.
Got it.
Beautiful.
Okay, so we found Pete's.
Ideal approaching.
Yeah, not ideal. He's not on the path, he's just here just off the path. but not actually close enough to the path to get a drop. The flag is there, so I mean he's close to the flag. Problem is he's got a little dinky tree in the way.
Yeah.
You've got to land over that, drop it on. I am, you'll just see me, where is it gone? There.
Not too bad, you let yourself an uphill foot there.
Yeah. It's not getting my gauge right yet, but it'll come. So up over this tree, probably quite a lot of respect to the left, would you say, still?
I'm going to go quite straight, because I don't think it's going to bounce loads when it lands.
Okay.
If it runs off a little bit to the right, it's going to be an uphill putt, which I've not had too many of yet. So.
Go for it. Go. Nice.
Yeah, I was almost too soft on that then.
Yeah,
nice. I felt really delicate on it. I thought it was
It's okay.
I didn't hit the tree, so.
That's true.
Rick is going to be coming up the hill. It's not actually up the hill all the way, which I thought it was going to do. It's coming up here then, almost breaking down and to the right, maybe? Rick's right. We'll see. Straight at it. Ooh. It's a good effort, mate. It's a very, very good effort.
I feel like I've rolled some really good putts.
Yeah, not been missing. Oh, wow, hello. That was close, that mate. You did well to miss it.
Ha. God, that was really like on the edge of picking that up then. Why that was such a big deal is we're playing stroke play, and I don't know about anybody else plays it, but you can't pick up your ball.
That would be frowned upon.
Yeah, Pete's got this for birdie. Slightly up the brow at the first, then flattens out at the top plateau here. Due one. Stay up.
Knew it was higher. I knew it should have gone higher.
That hole coming up as well. Good looking hole. I don't think that's the next hole actually, but.
Gonna water.
I think the next hole is just over our shoulder going down that way. It could be a biggie. Standard clean up here by Pete.
That's why they call him the cleaner.
That's why they called him the cleaner. Right, let's get on to the next. This feels like it's taking forever.
So 112 yard par 3, little tiny one up the hill. I really, really, really like the lookout. Like the lookout, like the layout of this course.
Nice, isn't it?
It's really good. Really good. I think what everyone was saying about it being fun was.
We're getting the gist of that.
Yeah, pretty accurate. So.
Slightly down breeze.
Gap wedge?
Yeah, like that little low one I played a couple of holes ago.
It does feel like the other day. Oh, is it going to be the same?
Double.
Where's it finished?
It like needed one big
hop. Oh yeah, got it. Yeah.
Never took that first big hop.
It looked great, again, flight wise.
Oh, it was lovely and low. And it just took that one check, maybe, I mean it's hard to tell, but maybe 15 feet short. And it needed that big hop before it spun back, and it didn't. It kind of dug its teeth in. And stopped immediately.
I'm gonna go a tiny bit higher, I think.
Okay. Looks like there's a little bit of a backstop behind the flag, to be fair, as well, which I've probably only just realised.
Roger's gonna
been a great deal, but it should stop. That's what I'm after.
Spin. Oh, it did spin.
Yeah.
That's nearly come back to mine.
It's not too much.
That's got a lot of spin on it.
What a grabby grab that, wasn't it?
So down the...
Spin. Oh, it
did. Not a bad view. This is the... I think this is probably the highest point on this course, but it's not the highest point on all the course.
Mark.
Is that my pitch mark?
Come back to that.
Thank you very much.
Here's me saying I didn't think it'd spin that much.
I was obviously deluding myself. Rick's pitched about there. Yeah, I don't think we were ever gonna get the little hop forward on here, were we?
Seems a little bit softer.
Yeah. Could have been straight at it. Distance wise.
Water for spin shots.
So, birdie put up the slope. How did you get this one, mate?
Straight.
Straight.
Big putt. Big putt.
Pulled it.
Yeah, not.
It was moving back round. It was almost...
I'll tell you what, if that was tracking online, I bet you wouldn't have said a thing.
Oh, if that was coming back.
It would just been right.
Nailed it. No, I knew it was a pull straight away. Okay, Pete for birdie.
Well, I know it's going to come a little bit right now.
Definitely due one.
I am due one.
Look at that. See right out to the sea over there. Wait if you can focus that in. Okay, come on. What we've all come for. The only reason we came to Spain was so you could birdie the sixth hole here on the Ruins course at Lumine. Oh, agonisingly close. That looked good as well.
A few lips today.
You've been confident with your putting.
Yeah, well, I'm getting a little bit more used to this, the feel of this putter.
To be fair, I only really wanted to just give this putter a go. I didn't have any intention of...
And this is like four rounds in, it's still there, rocking, yeah. Rocking in the bag. Good putt. Good putt. Stays at one over, I'm level. This hole is next. Let's do it.
As we look over Rick's right shoulder here, the seventh hole. Lovely driving hole, we think.
Yeah.
It's pretty much in between the edge of the trees and the bunkers. Doglegs around to the left, and the pin is... Is this one over water?
Yeah, I'm just going to rule where I can see it and then just turn it around the corner. This tee's inviting me to do that.
This is your shot, this one. Perfect. Perfect. It's just drawing round. It's going to be...
That was class.
That was good, that. We're saying this.
That was class.
We're saying this. There's probably like a 50-foot sinkhole there for
no,
the
No, that was class ball flight.
As far as what you were set up for and what you were hit, it looks amazing, so...
Whatever's happened, even if it's gone in the water, I'm happy with that golf shot, because that's exactly what I meant to do. Okay, Pete, same shot? Are you going to go a bit tighter over the trees?
Yeah, I'm not, I don't feel as comfortable drawing it as you at the moment, so...
Well, you've done nothing but hit the ball straight, if I'm honest.
So I'm
going to
go...
Wherever you want the ball to finish, that's where you aim.
Okay. I've got my aim. Roger that.
Oh, a little fade down there. Right in the middle of the fairway. Great shot.
Watching that with a lot of...
I know, yeah. I had no idea where that was going to land. I was looking at the water thinking, hold on, and it's like right in the middle of the fairway. Great shot.
It. Nailed it. 10 out of 10.
That's where we've just teed off from, all the way at the top of that hill. It's come down, and this is what we find. Beautiful hole. Pete's come down with so much height, it's literally plugged and stopped. Plugged and then hopped back up.
I think it's just controlling. It's just controlling ball flight. You know what? I'm controlling ball flight better than I'm controlling this bloody gorilla pod at the moment.
You got it?
Yes, sir.
I'm going to guess 152.
151. You are on fire today.
Honestly,
yeah.
It's pretty good that. It's not like me. I'm normally about that. I'm like 112. No, it's 160. Okay.
So breeze is flag was quite still. The breeze is definitely in off the right.
Yeah. Now I'm. I thought this opened up, but it doesn't. I'm just in the rough, just down the left. I was quite.
Quite a narrow fairway.
Really narrow. I was really gutted. It looked like if you bombed one on this line that Pete was on, you could have potentially hit in that water, but it's like another 100 yards.
So we're okay.
I think we were safe. Seven?
Yeah, seven.
Not down?
The gap.
Battery cut out. I had to scream at Pete to stop his swing. So battery changed. Sorry about me.
You know what?
It was flashing red, but I thought, you know what? We've got this.
It's lucky I'm chilled. It's lucky I am one chilled guy.
He was literally ready to go.
Right.
You good?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm there.
Little 7-iron. Drawing it in. Oh, it might have drawn too far. Did it just drew too far, I'm afraid.
Yeah, decent shot again. Missed it left. Come on.
Come on, man.
Like Rug was saying, just in the rough, not terrible lie.
I'm a bit devil because I thought it was like perfect. Like right around the corner.
Whoa. I'm sorry, you're what?
Devoed.
Devoed.
Devastated.
140 yards. Pin is. For a lot of people, that wouldn't be an inviting shot, but this suits your eye again, this.
Yeah, it's just in the rough. It's started nice, though. A little nine.
Yeah, come on round. Very safe, professional shot, that, mate.
Wasn't meant to be. But I'll take it.
Okay, Pete, just off the side of the green, is going to take a little wedge. Gap wedge, sand wedge?
Little
lob wedge, it's going to come down and off the hill. I am there towards the back. I'm just saying how far I seem to hit my 9-iron. It's just in miles.
I think sometimes silence speaks a thousand words. Oh, that was rubbish. That was rubbish. Took a lob wedge and it hit it. I need to be going for these holes. There's only a couple holes left and I am behind. I'm one behind. So Rick birdie put pretty much straight down the green.
Yeah.
Not a massive amount in it. Doesn't look like it anyway. I don't know where Rick is. It's coming straight down. It's got to sit a little. It's got to sit a little. It's a strong put, that. It's a strong effort.
Just fancy a little run at one. Just, you know, do you know what I mean?
Come on then, mate. You know the line. Straight back up this hill. We just want that nice, even roll. Stroke.
Good stroke.
Standard 2 foot.
Right, now if I've said this once, I've said this 1,000 times, you are due one, Peter Finch.
I know.
Right?
I am. Come on. You heard the man.
Go home, ball. You were due one. Right. The eighth hole is the one with the bunker in the middle of the green.
Oh, is it really?
Let's go over there.
Bring it on.
And we've reached the eighth hole, par three, with a bunker in the middle of the green. And it's 144, they say?
Yeah.
You going nine?
Yeah, I'm just getting a nice nine.
Nice smooth nine for Rick. I'm going to get one more, I think. Pretty good for distance, I think, just staying right slightly. Just right to the pin, good distance?
Yeah, well, no, I think it's a bit short actually. It was a bit bottom groove and not quite hit.
Not your Sunday best.
Definitely not the Sunday best. A nice shot, but I'm over the bunker in the green anyway, I think.
You're not gonna have to put through it. One more. No, 8 iron. Straight at it.
I think this is the right shot, this, to be fair, 8 iron. I think 9 was ambitious, slightly into breeze. Yes.
Hold on. Going the other way.
Next to mine, I think.
Yeah, literally over the top of yours.
Okay.
Yes. Hold on.
So as we get up to the green, we can see myself and Pete just on the other side there. And we luckily avoided this. Little random bunker in the putting green. I tell you what, I bet you get some, imagine some tasty pins here, Pete.
Oh, yeah.
Get a pin here. Yeah, that is weird. I've never seen that before. So if you're here, you'd literally have to chip it or put it around it or...
If I was a greenkeeper, I'd be hated here. I'd be...
Oh, you'd put some pins in some wicked spots, wouldn't you?
I wouldn't be admired. I'd be notorious.
Yeah, I was just saying, I think... It would have been good if that bunker would have been 4 times as long and right across the middle. But I have been out in the sun all day, maybe I'm just talking crazy. So, pretty long putt really,
yeah? Yeah, no, completely misjudged the distance out.
It's all across the green, it's about 30 feet or so. Looks like it's going to come in from the right.
Yeah.
Come on in. Good line, pretty much. Just not quite the legs.
The last hole scared me slightly.
You're gonna go ahead and
roll it in.
Tap it in. A little duck flapping away in the background. Yeah. It may or may not be advantage, but I know what it's going to do over the last 2 feet. I tried to close my eyes, but then I thought people would be angry if I didn't get this one.
Right, I'm due one.
Now that you've said it, you're definitely due one.
I'm due one now.
In fact, I feel like I'm on completely the wrong side here, because coming around this way is much more beautiful. For many reasons. One, we can see your face, Pete. And two, we can see that wonderful backdrop.
Get away from me a little bit.
Yeah, that's all it is. Okay, you know what it's going to do? Up the hill, down the hill, right to left. This to tide level, going down the last. Due one. Oh. Right, little knee knocker. See much in it?
I was just going to whistle until you said that.
Sorry.
Yeah, it will come off the left. Yeah, it's just pace. Just pace.
Tell you what, you've cleaned up on a lot of good putts today.
That's why they call me
the sweeper. Right, one hole to play, one shot advantage.
Last hole, one stroke in it. Level par for Rick versus, at this moment, one over for me. It looks like a long par four. I'm predicting it, well, a longish par four. Driver for both of us. Beautifully framed hole. Bunkers and trees everywhere. That was good. Yeah, nice shot, mate, over that bunker. Humdinger.
Should be good.
Absolute humdinger.
Just stayed up that right hand side, but it was a lovely hit. That's a lie, it's perfect.
Right then.
Got something to do here, Finch?
Got a job to do.
And if there's ever a man to do it, it's gonna be you.
You know what? Fancy this one.
Yeah. Give it a ride.
Hey there. Right here.
Sorry, I wasn't even zooming in.
The right of the car path.
Yeah.
Presuming it's come straight down, pretty thick there, man.
We'll have to go and find out. Okay, so we get down and it's only a short hole this. We've both bombed driver. Pete is there just in the rough, got plenty of room to get over that tree, so it's not an issue. How far have you got?
109.
Oh, honestly, I was just going to say 110. I'm there just in the fairway. Again, I've got that probably tree slightly more in my way potentially, but it's 100.
I'm not sure.
I think I've got that tree slightly in my way. We'll see.
Yeah. With a draw. And if not,
I'll just hit 56 big.
If not, I'm just going to lean on that side of it and just push it over. Just
lean on the tree, wow.
So I've got a 52. It's bang on the same distance as that par 3. So
just looking at it from this line, it looks great because it's like right between those two trees. It's actually, to a degree, you've almost got to slightly miss target left here, haven't you? Because that tree, if misjudged, yeah, the tree here, just literally to the right of the pin, looks like even the shadow is like level with the pin. So I think it's got to be one of those where it's either got to go absolutely at the pin or slightly left. Yeah, I think right, it's going to really be a dangerous golf shot.
It's going
to
be perfect.
Well, I think you need to make it up and down anyway, let's be honest. Track.
Pretty happy with that.
Yeah,
really.
Very nice shot. You see it just left of the flag? Nice shot, sir.
There you go.
I think the breeze just helped there, didn't it?
Yeah.
Breeze just slightly off the right.
I quite like shots like that, I know.
Nice shot, that.
No, this is the shot that could clinch it. Perfect drive.
Just left enough. Yeah, to squeeze past that tree.
Yeah, it shouldn't come into play. 106 left.
If I go straight out the flag, I think the breeze is going to bring it closer to yours.
Okay.
I can't take anything for granted. An up and down would secure it.
Yeah, that's just life in general. Can't take anything for granted. Up and down will secure it. That's not so much the best of all. Oh no, Rick, no!
Did you just...
Got tree scared.
Did he? Yeah. you were speaking with such confidence, I was like, okay, it's going to be good.
Well, I said to you, can I play a low fade around that tree?
I actually said no.
So it's probably my fault. I didn't let him do what he wanted to. The door. Has it opened? And it all comes down to this. One shot in it, Rick with a putt across the green, down to the pin. Hey, well, mate, if you get it down for two from there, think about the stats. Stats are going to look good. One putt green. So it's going to be down and from Rick's right, I think. Yeah. Come on down. Come on down. Come on down. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Oh. I believe in the business. That's what's known as a knee knocker.
It's a wide.
It's a wide. Yeah, I did see it coming down from the right as well, but it didn't really move, did it, to be honest?
It really didn't. Oh, sorry, I'm looking at my foot. I'm not even thinking that you've... you've actually got this for the win now. Well, no, actually, that's very really? Presumptuous that I'm going to miss this.
I'm not going to say I feel the confidence flowing from you at this moment in time.
I would rather this not go in, Pete.
You'd rather it not go in?
But you are due one. And when you're due one, normally it happens.
You know, I'd probably say I'm actually overdue. If my putting was a pregnancy, I think I'm at 12 months here.
And you're still not dropped.
Yeah, doctors are baffled.
I feel like I should come round this side and get the ruins in, considering that's the namesake of this golf course. You see it there in the background? Okay, this is it. It's a pile on an unprecedented amount of pressure on me if this drops.
You've got this.
You've got it, uh-oh. Don't hear Pete say that very often. And when he does, he normally delivers. Oh my goodness, that was proper heart in mouth. I thought that was in. Halves?
That's so many of them today.
You have. So for par, and to finish at one over. Yep. Right, this is for it.
It's annoying that. Nine holes of what ifs, what could have been. A lot of good putts, but just a lot of edges burned. However, this putt for level par. Yeah, very good. Never looked like anything else, that mate. Good putt.
Yeah, it did, in my head, it looked like everything but going in. Guys, do us a favour. If you've enjoyed that video, that was a big, long episode. And if you're still watching right now, well, I'll tell you something. Thank you.
Thank you very much, and well done.
Well done for getting through that.
Well done.
Guys, if you've enjoyed that video and you want to see a few more full nine-hole vlogs, let us know. Comment below. Also, stay tuned to right at the end of this video for a secret code word. Type that code phrase into the comments below, and you are our friends for life.
Are we going to put the code word in after? Or
yeah, I'll put it in.
Okay.
Do you want to do it now? Do you know a code word? Tell people what they're going to comment below. Okay. Tell you what, here's what we want to comment below.
Spanish snake charmer.
Spanish... snake charmer.
Gondola.
There you go. Guys, don't forget to subscribe to Pete, subscribe to me by clicking the big circles in the corner. Do like, comment, Spanish snake charmer. That will confuse a lot of people who didn't watch all the way to the end of the video. Thanks, Lumina, for letting us come down here and film. It's been beautiful. This is the last of the course vlogs. Hopefully you enjoyed the pro tracers that we featured in that video as well. And we'll see you soon. A win for me.